This weekend we're going with a bunch of friends. They're all coming down for my birthday, which is pretty awesome.
Welcome to Kruger Park.
We've got five people loaded up with all of their camping gear in Jabari, which is pretty remarkable. Taking quite a lot less of the recovery gear and that sort of thing than we normally carry. In the south of the park this time, can't f***ing wait, it's gonna be amazing. I have a strange relationship with Johannesburg. It will always be a part of me. It's where my family live. It's where I grew up. It is madness. It shouldn't exist. The mix of cultures, the danger. It's an incredible city with an incredible energy. But I'm also always very excited to leave, especially these days with Bianca and Jabari. Jabari just turned 100, and rather appropriately, we are in the middle of a road trip, so it's a suitable place to turn 100. Absolutely beautiful. On our way to Kruger, we're a little park halfway now. Can't wait to get there. Just getting out of the city. It's incredible. The anticipation is palpable. We're finally there. And then, as if to welcome us, the kings came walking down the road.
Can you still see him?
Yeah.
Where is he?
We had a late night around the fire and started early the next morning for a lazy day in the park. Satara didn't disappoint. This part of the park is famous for massive prides of lions that rule the plains. But being king, they spend a lot of time lying around conserving their energy.
Look at them playing up there in there. the cup.
Open this one already. Make sure it's clean and everything.
So these f***ers surprised me with drinks and a private game drive for my birthday in Kruger. And they couldn't have planned it, but we somehow managed to see a leopard on a kill, and then an entire herd of elephant came walking past while we were sitting on this rock watching the sunset right by Satara with the head ranger of Satara. There's no words. It's unbelievable. What an incredible day. What great people celebrating this day with me. Absolutely love it. We're gonna have a party tonight. You best believe it. Probably the greatest nature reserve in the world, and there's no one else here. This is all for my birthday because some special people spoiled the crap out of me. This is unbelievable.
As can be expected, we had a really slow start that morning. It was everyone else's last day, so we took a long drive out to the northeast of Satara. The plains out there are incredible. It was incredible to spend some time with like-minded friends in the park, but they needed to return to real life, and we had just extended our stay yet again.
So we have three female lions to ourselves now. It's quite exciting in Kruger when you have a sighting to yourself. There goes a big yawn.
We're sitting with a group of male cheetahs. They seem to definitely be hunting. So we're just really hoping that they're hunting something near to us. It's an absolutely scorching hot day, so it's difficult for them to move around. It's 38 degrees at the moment. It was hitting 40 earlier. It's 3 o'clock, so the temperature should start to cool a little bit. They do look like they're very hungry. They're very skinny. It looks like they haven't eaten in a while. We're hoping that they're going to hunt in this direction so that we can stay relatively close, because one of the problems, it's not really a problem, but one of the things with Kruger is that you can't go off-road at all. So if they move off into that block, we've got no chance of finding them. There's about probably 20 kilometers in that direction before there's another road that we're allowed to use. But yeah, so hold done. There's three cheetah that are definitely hunting, and we had brilliant visual on them. They crossed the road right in front of us. They've now moved off. They're about probably about 200 meters in that direction. I can still pick them up on the camera, but with the heat haze, you can barely even get a shot. But yeah, let's see what happens.
We didn't get to see the cheetah hunting, but just down the road, we found a batelier on its own kill, a very unfortunate lizard. We bumped into this little guy and his family on the S100. Unfortunately, it was just before the gates closed, so we couldn't really sit with him for long. Another incredible day in the park, and we were in store for something really special tomorrow. It was our last full day in Satara, so we headed out early towards the Timbavati picnic site for breakfast. Someone had beaten us to it though.
This is our fifth lion sighting in 5 days, which is quite incredible. Satara is definitely living up to its reputation as a great spot to see lion. And we're right by the Timbavati picnic spot right now. Literally, it's less than 100 meters in that direction, which is a little bit disconcerting because we were having breakfast there the other day, cooking bacon and eggs. There was a single lioness on a zebra kill here, but there's another lioness that has come to join her now. And we did hear a lion calling earlier. Both of these lionesses seem to be injured as well, interestingly. So I'm not sure what played out last night, but it must have been pretty dramatic. I'm guessing they either fought off other lions for the kill, or maybe another pride of lions tried to take the kill from them after they had made it. Or there was an epic battle with hyenas. It's one of those things you never really know. The bush is full of secrets, and we only get to observe a tiny little portion of what happens. You can see the lioness is feeding again. They don't waste energy getting through the outside of the hide, where it's really thick and quite difficult to chew through, and should take a lot of energy. They pretty much primarily eat through the stomach, so it looks even gorier than it is. But you know, they dig in through the stomach cavity and around the asshole when they get in there. As Bianca says, it can be pretty ew. As you can see there, she's eating the stomach lining there. But food is food. You can see that these two lionesses were in a big fight for this meal. We're not sure if it was with the zebra, I don't think so. The zebra can sometimes injure a lion, but it'll just injure one from a kick. It's unlikely that a zebra injured multiple lions, so I'm guessing that there was a fight with other predators, yeah.
Satara has been incredible. I've never had so many lion sightings in my life, but we must continue south. Our next stop is Kakuza, the biggest camp in the park, so expect the most cars, but also unbelievably high game densities. Trust me, you do not want to miss next week's episode.